वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू अनादर क्लास ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 4. नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज मोर ऑन पावर पॉइंट. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी दैट पावर पॉइंट इट गिव्स अस द एज टू प्रेजेंट आवर डेटा विद चार्ट्स, डायग्राम्स, फोटोज, क्लिप आर्ट्स एंड आई कैचिंग टेक्स्ट, साउंड, कलर्स, डिजाइन एंड एनिमेटेड स्पेशल इफेक्ट. द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस थिंग इज PowerPoint provides you a facility by which we can represent our data in an effective way. The way can be either it will be in the form of charts, or we can insert diagrams, photos, moving arts, or you can say eye-catching text, that is text with a motion, colors, sound, design and other special effects we can provide with the help of PowerPoint. Now a presentation, it is a collection of slides that are arranged in a sequential manner, that means in a one by one manner by which we can entertain, motivate, convey or give information to the large audience, you can say. Okay, so let's talk about some important features of MS PowerPoint. So what are the facilities or features provided by MS Office? They are written here. First is, it is an built-in tools of the applications are impressive. With the help of PowerPoint, we can create a application that or you can say a effective presentation in which we can represent data easily inserted from Word or any other file. The meaning of this thing is that we can take data from MS Word and we can represent that in an effective manner using PowerPoint. Okay, and it can be projected on a big screen, like in auditorium. Maybe you have seen some movie or some presentation that is presented on a big screen. So this PowerPoint presentation, it can be projected, or you can say presented on big screen also with the help of projector. Okay, now next topic given here is planning a presentation. That means how you can create your presentation. So for creating a presentation, planning is necessary. You can say planning means you are creating some way out of that how you want to present that particular presentation. So planning is the most important step in creating a successful presentation of any kind. Before making a presentation, we need to plan the brief idea. That means whenever you're starting some work, you are just planning for that work, that how you have to do that thing. Okay, so similarly, whenever you're creating a presentation, you have to make a brief plan regarding the task. So planning helps us to decide the content and the order in which the information will be presented. Okay, so before creating any presentation, you should know the topic of presentation, and then you will plan according to the topic. Okay, second thing is design menu of MS PowerPoint. So PowerPoint 2016 opens with the presentation gallery. If you want to present something, you will find this type of presentation gallery in Microsoft PowerPoint 2016. So this provides several ways, different ways to start the next presentation. There are inbuilt template. Template means these types of designs you will get in MS PowerPoint 2016 inbuilt. Okay, it is having a theme, text style or color background. Automatically you will find that thing, or even a blank presentation also you will find. So here it is a given and is an image, that presentation gallery. It is also given in your book also, so you can check from that gallery. Okay, so once you make your choice for this presentation gallery, click on create button, you will see the actual PowerPoint interface, wherein in blank slide with the selected design will appear. Okay, so like this you can create your you can select your design menu for your presentation. Okay, next is select slide layout. So for selecting a slide layout, that means how you want title and other content. So you can go on select slide layout. So for that, you have to click on the layout button that is present on the home tab of the ribbon. Ribbon is the particular area where you will find different types of tab that we have seen in MS Word also. So similarly, in PowerPoint also, you will find the tabs. And in layout home tab, you will find a layout button of the ribbon. And when you click on that ribbon or layout tab, you will find a drop-down menu, and then you can select the best suited layout content for your slide. Okay. You can customize the slide layout using Slide Master. That means there is another way by which we can create, edit, or change slides by using Slide Master. So Slide Master view is an important view within PowerPoint 2016. And because if you make any changes or edit within this particular view, these modifications will influence other slides also in your presentation. That is, automatically they will be affected in other slides also. For example, if you want to make a picture appear on all the slides, you will have to add the picture within the Slide Master. Or if you want the front size, font size of your slide titles must be little or smaller, then those edits also need to be made in Slide Master. Okay, so you can press Control M to insert a new slide also. So like this, you can you create your slide layout. Okay, now we will see some of the steps. So some steps, following are the steps to customize the layout at the slide. Okay, so you have to follow these steps. Okay, so step one is you have to click on views tab. Okay, that is present on the ribbon. And after that, you have to click on Slide Master button. Once you click on Slide Master button, then the slide layout appear as a thumbnail. That means you will find this as a thumbnail. Thumbnail means small icon in the left pane below the Slide Master. That is given here in the form of image. You can check and click the layout you want and customize it. And then you have to follow certain steps to add, remove, or resize the placeholders. Placeholders means small boxes. Okay. So to add a placeholder in a blank slide, click on the slide and then click on insert placeholder. So like that, you can insert a placeholder or a container on your slide. Step two is select the type of placeholder you want to add. To resize a placeholder, drag the corners. You will find the broad or small size corner arrows. So by dragging and dropping that particular arrows, you can resize your placeholder. And if you want to delete a placeholder, then you have to select the border of the placeholder and then you have to press a delete key. So like this, you can adjust, or you can say you can customize your layout with placeholders. Okay. Next is how we can apply color variations. Okay. That means how we can add colorful themes. So to add colorful themes with special fonts, fonts means alphabets, and effects, that means appearance, click the Slide Master tab and then you can click on themes in edit themes. So in the right hand side, format background is given. So from that we can change the colors. Okay. So you have to apply a different color variation of a particular theme, then click on colors. In next class, I will show the demonstration of this particular chapter. So right now we are discussing the theory part and then we will do the practical. And from the drop down menu, you have to pick color you want and then you can format it. So now we will discuss how we can format a background color of slides. So you can format the background of a slide with color or a fill pattern. That means we can change the entire color of the slide, or we can change the fill pattern. That means sliding lines if you want that thing, or you can apply a solid color, particular fixed colors or an image, etc. as a background to your slide. So first is apply a solid color to background. Solid means a dark color. Okay. So click on the background style drop down arrow in the background group that you will find in format tab. You have to go on format tab and then you have to click on background group. Okay, and then click on the background format from the mini dialog box. Then you will you have to select the solid fill, as you can see in the image, and this same image is given in your book also. So you have to select on solid fill on the background format and then just click on okay. Then select the color, then choose the color that you want from the drop down menu, and to apply the color to all the slides in your presentation, select apply to all, and then to change the background transparency. Transparency means like whenever we are seeing on the slide that something is like darker or lighter, you can move the transparency slider and you can change the percentage of transparency. That means fully opaque. Default setting, it will provide 100% transparency. So you can change the transparency option also. Okay. So this next is, we can also change the size of your slides also. So the default size in PowerPoint 2013 and 16 is widescreen. That means 16:9 ratio. This is the size of the slide. We can change it also. So you can resize your slide to 4:3, or even you can make it smaller or larger by changing the view or by selecting the particular option. Okay, so the slide size is also available in Slide Master. You have to click on View on the Slide Master tab and then you can change it. So some of the steps are given here to change the size of your slide. So step one is, you have to click on Format tab of the ribbon and then click on Slide Size. After clicking on Slide Size, you will find the standard 4:3 or widescreen 16:9 options are there. You can select any option that is given in image also. So that is up to you which size you want. Okay. When the PowerPoint is unable to automatically scale your content, it will promote you with two options. You can maximize or you can use ensure fit option. Okay, so that is up to you which option you want to use. So select this option, maximize, to increase the size of your slide content when you are scaling to a larger slide size. If you want large size, then you can go on maximize and you can choose that. Okay, choosing this option could result in your content not fitting on the particular slide. And then second option is ensure fit. Selecting this option to decrease the size of your content when scaling to a smaller or larger slide. So 16:9 widescreen setting is the default. That means automatically available for new presentation. When you change the slide size for a presentation, the size you choose only applies to that particular presentation. If you are taking new slide, then it will be of the previous size. Okay, so this is all about today's class and we will continue this topic. Next is, resize slides to custom dimensions. That means according to customer's requirement, you can resize your slides also. So steps are given. You have to go on Format tab of the ribbon and then you have to click on Slide Size and then you have to click on Custom Slide Size. After that, you will find the slide size dialog box will appear. It is given in the image also. What you have to do is, you have to set the height and width dimensions and the orientation from this dialog box. And then click down the arrow next to the slide size and pick an option. Options are given here, you will find. So you change according to the options given and then click on OK. So like that, you can resize the slides to the required dimension. That means dimension is given by you or selected by you. So like this, you can resize your presentation. Okay. So we will continue this chapter in the next class also. This is all about today's class. Thank you.